जय हिंद टू ऑल ऑफ यू. टुडेज टॉपिक इज रेक्टिफायर. दैट हैज बीन टेकन फ्रॉम द सब्जेक्ट फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इंजीनियरिंग. एंड दिस सब्जेक्ट इज रनिंग इन द फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर ऑफ एकेटीयू सिलेबस. एंड माई सेल्फ इज नेहा गर्ग, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ईसी डिपार्टमेंट, AKGEC. सो बेसिकली रेक्टिफायर इज अ डिवाइस दैट कन्वर्ट्स द ऑल्टरनेटिंग करेंट इन टू पल्सेटिंग DC करेंट. Like we have a power supply in which there is a transformer is there, and after that there will be a rectifier, and after that there will be a filter, and after that there will be a regulator. So this is the transformer. Transformer provides the AC signal, and rectifier converts this AC signal into pulsating DC. Like this is our AC signal. This is our AC signal, and this AC is the input signal, and this rectifier will convert this AC into DC. So it will be like in this way. Output will be like in this way. So this output, this is called the pulsating AC, pulsating DC, because the DC will be a constant voltage, but we are getting this output. So this output is in pulsating form. So rectifier provides a pulsating DC output, and this filter consists of the capacitor, and this capacitor it provides a constant output like in this way. And this rectifier, this regulator basically consists of the circuit that is having the Zener diode, and Zener diode it provides a constant DC voltage. Like this is the output of the Zener diode, this is for the Zener diode, and this is for the filter circuit, and this is for the rectifier circuit. So basically rectifier is used to convert the AC signal into the DC signal, and it is used in the power supply. So rectifier is of two types. First one is the half wave rectifier, and another one is the full wave rectifier. So half wave rectifier, it will convert the one of the cycle of the input signal. Like this is our input signal. This is the positive cycle of the input signal, and this is the negative cycle of the input signal. So half wave rectifier, it will convert, either it will convert only the positive cycle or it will convert the negative cycle. Like this is the structure for the half wave rectifier, and it has only one diode and one resistor, and this VI is the input AC signal that we want to rectify. So in positive cycle of this input signal, this diode will be forward bias, because this P side is connected with the positive polarity. So this diode will be forward bias, and if it is forward bias, it will be short circuit. So in that case, output voltage V0 would be equal to VI, but in the negative cycle, this diode will be in reverse bias, so it will act as a open circuit, and in that case output voltage would be zero. So for this type of configuration, when diode is forward bias in positive cycle, we have a output like in this way, but in the negative cycle output is zero, so there is no output in this case. And if we change the direction of the orientation of the diode, so this circuit will be in this way. Okay, here it will be output and here it will be input. So here this orientation of the diode, in this orientation the diode will be forward bias in negative cycle. So in that case the output will be, so in this case the output will be this case, because it will be forward bias in negative cycle. So only this AC signal, it will be forward bias in negative cycle, so only negative cycle we are getting the output in this way. So half wave rectifier means it will convert the only one of the input cycle, either it may be the positive cycle or it may be the negative cycle, only one of the cycle in positive or negative we are getting the output. So this is the half wave rectifier. Like here we can see डायोड इज देयर एंड ही दिस इज द वी आई साइकिल इज देयर इन द पॉजिटिव साइकिल पॉजिटिव इनपुट साइकिल दिस इन दिस साइकिल दिस डायोड इज फॉरवर्ड बायस सो इट इज शॉर्ट सर्किट एंड वी आर गेटिंग द आउटपुट इन दिस वे सो दिस इज द पीक वैल्यू ऑफ द आउटपुट वी एम एंड दिस इज द पीक वैल्यू ऑफ द इनपुट सिग्नल वी एम एंड दिस लाइन शोज द वी डी सी वैल्यू दैट इज द वी एवरेज वैल्यू दैट वी विल बी कैलकुलेटेड इन फर्दर स्लाइड्स सो दिस इज हाउ वी विल कैलकुलेट द एवरेज वैल्यू और द वी डी सी वैल्यू इन हाफ वेव रेक्टिफायर सो इन हाफ वेव रेक्टिफायर वी हैव सीन लाइक दिस इज अवर इनपुट दिस इज द ए सी इनपुट वी हैव एंड दिस इज अवर आउटपुट दिस वॉज इनपुट वी आई एंड दिस इज आउटपुट लाइक इन दिस वे सो दिस इज फ्रॉम जीरो पाई एंड टू पाई सो वी आर गेटिंग आउटपुट फ्रॉम जीरो टू पाई एंड फ्रॉम पाई टू टू पाई इट विल बी जीरो सो फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग द एवरेज वी हैव टू फाइंड द एवरेज फ्रॉम द एरिया दैट इज कवर्ड बाय दिस वी इनपुट सो वी डी सी वी कैन कैलकुलेट बाय दिस फॉर्मूला दैट इज फ्रॉम वन अपॉन टू पाई इट विल बी योर जीरो वन अपॉन टू पाई जीरो टू टू पाई वी एम साइन ओमेगा टी वी एम साइन ओमेगा टी एंड वी कैन सी हियर वन अपॉन टू पाई जीरो टू पाई इट विल बी वी एम साइन ओमेगा टी एंड फ्रॉम पाई टू टू पाई इट विल बी जीरो फ्रॉम पाई टू टू पाई इट विल बी जीरो सो दिस इज हाउ वी कैन कैलकुलेट द वी डी सी बिकॉज वी कैन सी दिस वेव विल बी रिपीटेड आफ्टर टू पाई जीरो टू टू पाई वी कैन सी दिस इज जीरो टू टू पाई दिस पैटर्न इज लाइक इन दिस वे सो दिस पैटर्न विल बी रिपीटेड आफ्टर टू पाई पीरियड सो दैट्स वाई वी हैव रिटन हियर वन अपॉन टू पाई एंड इंटीग्रेशन इज फ्रॉम जीरो टू टू पाई and we can write it also 0 to pi and pi to 2 pi so by after solving this 1 upon 2 pi it will be like vm sin omega t is your cos omega t minus cos omega t and 0 to pi so after solving this we will be having vm upon pi so in case of half wave rectifier the vdc output or v average output will be equal to vm upon pi So similarly, we can calculate the VRMS voltage, that is the root mean square voltage. So root mean square voltage we can calculate by squaring the input voltage, that is Vm sin omega t. We can find the square of this voltage, Vm sin square omega t. And after that, we have to VRMS. Actually, VRMS stands for root mean square. So we have to find the first of all square, after that mean, and after that root. So square will be Vm sin square omega t, and for root, for mean, we what we will do? We will calculate the 0 to 2 pi, and upon 1 upon 2 pi. And for finding root, we will do like in this way. So this is how we can calculate the root mean square value of the half wave rectifier. And by solving the sin square omega t, the integration will be by sin square omega t can be written as 1 minus cos 2 omega t. And by solving the integration, we will be having the value of Vm by 2. So in half wave rectifier, we have obtained the VDC value as Vm upon pi and VRMS value as Vm upon 2. So these two values we have obtained, and see, all these operations will also be performed in the full wave rectifier. Now the what will be the value of the ripple factor? So ripple factor is actually the ratio of the AC component to the DC component in the rectifier. So we have seen that half wave rectifier, we have a input wave like this, and output wave is in this form. So output wave, output signal is not completely DC. If it will be DC, it will be like in this form. This is pure DC, like it will be 10 volt or 2 volt. So it is the pure DC form. But here we are getting the output voltage in the form of a pulsating DC. This is a pulsating DC. So these pulses that are we are getting, these are called the ripples. So these ripples. So here ripple factor will be calculated like VAC upon VDC, and VAC is equal to VRMS square minus VDC square, and this will be VDC square, and we can write it as VRMS square upon VDC square minus 1. So it would be equal to VRMS value we have obtained as Vm upon by 2 and VDC as Vm upon pi. So it whole square and minus 1. So it will be 1.21. By solving this, we will get 1.21. So this is the ripple factor value in half wave rectifier. So similarly, we will calculate in the full wave rectifier also. And this ripple factor, it indicates the amount of the ripples and amount of the AC component in the obtained results, that is the DC output that we are getting. In that output, how much amount of AC component is there. So this is the ripple factor in case of the half wave rectifier. So after that, efficiency in case of the half wave rectifier. So efficiency is basically indicates the output upon input, how much output we are getting, means how much amount of DC output we are getting by giving the any input signal. So that is your output DC power upon input AC power. And like we have a circuit in this way, this was diode, and here we have an input signal like plus minus, and here there is a resistance is there, output is there. So we know that at the output side there is a DC average power, that will be calculated by PDC. PDC would be equal to IDC square multiplied by RL. This resistance is your RL, so IDC square multiplied by RL is the PDC output. And PAC output, that is the AC output, that is AC output that is delivered by the this AC signal. So that is we can calculate with the help of the resistance of the diode and the load resistance, that is RF plus RL. So PAC would be equal to IRMS square multiplied by RF plus RL. So this is the how we can calculate the PAC, how we can calculate the PDC. So the ratio of this PDC and PAC, it will gives the efficiency of the half wave rectifier, and by solving this we will have the value of 40.6%. So this is the efficiency in the case of the half wave rectifier. Now we have to calculate the peak inverse voltage. So peak inverse voltage is basically the maximum voltage that the diode can withstand when it is in the reverse bias condition and before going to the breakdown region. So for calculating the PIB value, what we can do, we can so this is our diode and this is resistance. We are calculating the output across this resistance. This is the input signal. So we have to find the condition when our diode will be in reverse bias. So this is the P type and this is the N type. So this diode will be in reverse bias when this side will be negative and this side will be positive. So this is the PIB of the diode. The at the voltage across this point, across this time when the diode is in reverse bias, that voltage will be PIB. So this is the peak value of VI is here VM. This is the peak value of. So we can apply KVL here. So we will have our voltage drop across this diode would be equal to Vm. So in that case, PIB will be equal to Vm by applying KVL here, because this diode will be open circuit. So here V naught would be, in this case V naught would be 0, and this is the PIB. So minus plus. So we can apply KVL here. So Vi, by applying KVL, we will be having Vi plus Vi minus PIB is equal to 0. So Vi is equal to PIB. So this is how we can calculate the, here it will be negative and here it will be positive, then only it will be reverse bias. and in that case PIV would be equal to VM. So there is a numerical on the half wave rectifier. So here we have given the input signal VI, whose VM value is given as 20 volt. And this is a diode. So this diode will be forward bias. Its N side is here and P side is here. So this is the input signal. So this diode will be forward bias only in the negative cycle. And in that case, the output waveform will be like in this way. This is the input waveform, and output would be like here. We are getting the output only in the negative cycle, and we have obtained the value of VDC, that is your VM upon pi. So VM value is your 20. So we will put the 20 upon pi. So this is your this is VM upon pi VDC output. Now the full wave rectification. So full wave rectifier converts the AC signal into the DC signal in both positive and negative cycle of the input. Like this is the input signal, and half full wave rectifier, like in half wave rectifier we have seen, it will convert the it will operate either in the positive cycle or in the negative cycle, but full wave rectifier will operate in both cycles, negative and positive. So this is the input waveform and this is the output. So in output we can obtain cycles like in this way, or we can obtain cycles in this way, like in this way. So this is how your output is there. In positive cycles we are getting the output, and negative cycles we are also getting the output. So the efficiency of the full wave rectifier will be more in comparison to the half wave rectifier, because we are getting output in both cycles. This is also the output, and these outputs, either we are getting the positive cycles or we are getting the negative side cycles. It depends upon the polarity of the diodes, orientation of the diodes, how we have connected that diodes to make a full wave rectifier. And full wave rectifier is of two types: bridge rectifier and center tap rectifier. So in bridge rectifier we generally use 4 diodes, and in center tap rectifier we use only 2 diodes. So full wave rectifier has a transformer utilization factor that is equal to 0.8, and center tap rectifier has a transformer utilization factor that is 0.6. So transformer utilization factor means how much we can utilize the efficiency of the transformer. Like in the previous slides we have calculated the efficiency of the rectifier, half wave rectifier, that we have calculated by the formula PDC upon PAC. But this is the efficiency of the rectifier, means how much amount of AC signal we have given to the rectifier and how much amount of output, DC output, we are getting from the rectifier. But transformer utilization factor is the efficiency of the transformer. Like primary winding is there, secondary winding is there. So at primary winding, how much amount of input we have given, and we have how much is there at the secondary side. So TUF of the bridge rectifier is more in comparison to the TUF of center tap rectifier. So in bridge rectifier, this is the circuit for the bridge rectifier, in which we are having the 4 diodes like D1, D2, D3 and D4. And we have an input signal. This is our input signal, sine wave. So if we see the positive cycle of this input signal, in this positive cycle we have a like this. So in this positive cycle, this end will be positive and this end will be negative. So when this end is positive and this end is negative, in this case in positive cycle D2 and D3 is forward biased. In negative cycle D1 and D4 is forward biased. Okay, so in positive cycle D2 and D3 is forward biased, and D1 and D4 is reverse biased. So equivalent circuit will be like in this way. एंड दिस विल बी ओपन लाइक दिस इज प्लस दिस इज माइनस. ओके दिस इज प्लस दिस इज माइनस. सो डायरेक्शन ऑफ करंट वुड बी लाइक इन दिस वे. ओके सो करंट इज फ्लोइंग फ्रॉम हियर टू हियर. सो दैट्स व्हाई दिस पार्ट विल बिकम प्लस एंड दिस विल बिकम माइनस. डायरेक्शन ऑफ करंट इज लाइक इन दिस वे. सो हियर वी आर गेटिंग द आउटपुट. दिस इज इन द पॉजिटिव हाफ साइकिल एंड इन नेगेटिव हाफ साइकिल द सर्किट विल बी लाइक इन दिस वे. दिस इज माइनस दिस इज प्लस एंड दिस विल बी फॉरवर्ड बायस. दिस इज द रेजिस्टेंस. दिस विल बी ओपन. दिस इज ओपन एंड दिस इज शॉर्ट लाइक इन दिस वे एंड दिस इज प्लस. ओके नेगेटिव हाफ साइकिल द डायोड डी फोर एंड डी वन विल बी फॉरवर्ड बायस एंड डी टू एंड डी थ्री विल बी रिवर्स बायस. सो डायरेक्शन ऑफ करंट वुड बी लाइक इन दिस वे. ओके सो हियर ऑल्सो द आउटपुट वोल्टेज वुड बी लाइक दिस वे प्लस माइनस. सो इन बोथ साइकिल्स वी कैन सी डायरेक्शन ऑफ करंट इज सेम इन द रेजिस्टेंस. हियर डायरेक्शन ऑफ करंट इज दिस एंड हियर ऑल्सो डायरेक्शन ऑफ करंट इज दिस. सो इफ यू प्लॉट इनपुट वेव फॉर्म एंड आउटपुट वेव फॉर्म वी हैव लाइक दिस. दिस इज द इनपुट एंड दिस इज द आउटपुट. सो इन आउटपुट इन पॉजिटिव साइकिल वी आर गेटिंग द आउटपुट लाइक दिस इन दिस वे. इन नेगेटिव साइकिल वी आर गेटिंग द आउटपुट in this way because in both cycles we are getting the output in the same direction. So the both in both cycles the output in the same direction like in above the zero axis. And if we are taking this output with opposite polarity like we replace this and we make it minus and we make it positive, so in that case the output voltage will be in negative direction in this way. So this is the output DC that we are getting, but this DC is not pure. This DC is not pure. There is a ripples in the DC output that we are getting. Here we can see in positive cycle the diode and this diode are forward bias, so direction of current will be like this. In negative cycle this diode and this diode is forward bias, so direction of current is like this. So we are getting the output in this way. Now the second one is the center tap transformer. So difference between the bridge rectifier and center tap rectifier is that in center tap we have used only two diodes and in bridge rectifier we have used the four diodes. And there is also a difference between the PIV of the bridge rectifier and center tap rectifier. Like in center tap rectifier we also require a transformer, that is the center tap transformer. And in this transformer we have this is the primary winding and these are the secondary winding S1 and S2, and this is the point, tapping point is there by which the input voltage is divided into two halves. Like we will take a first cycle, that is a positive cycle of the input signal. So in this positive cycle, like this is the positive cycle, so this side will be positive plus minus and this side will be plus and this side will be minus. So in positive cycle, in positive cycle diode D1 is forward biased and diode D2 is reverse biased. So the circuit will be in this form. Okay, so here this is the R and this circuit will be here, it will be open circuit because it is reverse biased. Okay, so this Vm is plus minus, this Vm is plus minus. So here direction of current would be like in this way. And similarly here when in negative half cycle this will be negative, this will be positive, this will be negative, this will be positive. So in negative cycle what will happen, diode D2 will be forward biased and D1 will be reverse biased in negative cycle. So equivalent circuit would be like this. This would be open and there will be a resistance here and it will be short, and in that case this will be plus this will be this will be minus, this will be plus, this will be minus, and this will be plus. And direction of current would be like in this way. Okay, so in both cycles, positive and negative, both cycles, direction of current in resistance R is same. So we can plot the draw the output waveform here. In positive cycle, we are getting the output like this way, and in negative cycle also we are getting the output in this way. So in positive and negative, both cycles, the direction of current in resistance R is same. That's why we are getting the output in this way. And if we take like current is flowing here, so output we have taken plus minus. If the orientation of the output is changed, like it is plus and it is minus, then the output current would be, output voltage would be like in this way. This is the output voltage. Now in this diagram we can also calculate the PIV of the diode. So PIV of the diode, we have to calculate the PIV of this diode D1. PIV means the maximum reverse voltage across the diode, which the diode can withstand before going to the breakdown region. So for making this diode reverse bias, we have to make this negative and we may have to make to this positive. And it will be possible only when it will be a, there will be a negative cycle, means here negative and here positive. So in that case, this diode will be open circuit and this will be short circuit. And we can calculate the voltage across this diode. So it will be equal to 2 VM. So PIV will be equal to 2 VM in case of the center tap rectifier. Like this is for the we are taking only the positive cycle. So this diode is short, this diode is reverse bias, so output is like in this way. And if you are taking the negative cycle, so only this diode is forward bias, this diode is reverse bias, and it will behave as open circuit. So the output waveform is like in this way. So now we have to calculate the VRMS value of the full wave rectifier. So similarly, in the case that we have calculated in the half wave rectifier, what we have to do, we have to square the waveform like Vm sin omega t. So we have to square this. First is the square, this is the square. After that we have to find the mean. So for finding mean, what we have to do, we have to find the mean value. So we have to 0 to pi and after that 1 upon pi. Why we have written here 0 to pi? Because we are getting the output like in this way. This was our input and we are getting the cycles in this way. Okay, so these cycles are 0, pi, 2 pi and 3 pi. So there is a repetition after pi. Repetition after a pi. So that's why we have written here 0 to pi and 1 upon pi. And after that we will do the root of this. So by solving this equation, we will have this value Vm upon 2 pi. In full wave, we can see the repetition is at the 0 to pi. But in half wave, what was the case? It was like in this way. It was the repetition at the 2 pi. So that's why we have written the 1 upon 2 pi. But in full wave, there is a repetition at 0 to pi. That's why we have written the 0 to pi. So by solving this, we can calculate it will be equal to Vm upon root 2. In half wave, it was Vm upon 2. And after that, VDC value. So VDC value, same thing is there. We are getting in full wave rectifier, this is the case. And output is like in this way. So 0 to pi, 0, pi, 2 pi. So there is a repetition at 0 to pi. So that's why we have, and in average value, we have to find the area covered by this waveform. So for that purpose, Vm sin omega t, 0 to pi, 1 upon pi, and that is d omega t. So by solving this, we can calculate it will be equal to 2 Vm upon pi. Integration of sin omega t is minus cos omega t. Cos omega t, we can solve this integration and the value would be 2 Vm upon pi. So after that, the ripple factor in the case of the full wave rectifier, similarly we have calculated in the half wave, it is the ratio of the VAC upon VDC. VAC, why VAC we have taken? Because we are getting the ripples. दिस रिपल्स आर ड्यू टू द एसी कंपोनेंट दैट इज प्रेजेंट इन द डीसी आउटपुट. तो सो अमाउंट ऑफ एसी सिग्नल इन द डीसी आउटपुट इट इज द रिपल फैक्टर. सो वी एसी अपॉन वी डीसी एंड दिस सो वी कैन कैलकुलेट दिस वी एसी. वी एसी वुड बी इक्वल टू वी आर एम एस स्क्वेयर माइनस वी डी सी स्क्वेयर एंड वी आर एम एस स्क्वेयर अपॉन वी डी सी स्क्वेयर माइनस वन. सो वी कैन पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ वी आर एम एस. वी आर एम एस हियर इट इज वी एम अपॉन रूट टू एंड वी डी सी इट वुड बी इक्वल टू टू वी एम अपॉन पाई. सो इट विल बी सो एफिशियंसी ऑफ द फुल वेव रेक्टिफायर वी कैन कैलकुलेट पी डी सी अपॉन पी ए सी. सो दैट विल बी इक्वल टू पी डी सी वुड बी इक्वल टू आई डी सी स्क्वेयर अपॉन मल्टीप्लाइड बाई आर एल एंड पी ए सी इज इक्वल टू दिस. सो दैट सिमिलरली वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड इन द हाफ वेव रेक्टिफायर ऑल्सो. सो दैट सेम थिंग विल बी यूज इन द फुल वेव रेक्टिफायर ऑल्सो बट वी हैव टू रिप्लेस द वैल्यू ऑफ आई एम एंड आई आर एम एस हियर. सो एफिशियंसी वुड बी इक्वल टू 81.2%. एंड पी आई वी आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड यू हाउ वी कैन कैलकुलेट द पी आई वी. We can calculate the PIV by keeping one of the diode in the reverse bias mode. And we can apply here KVL. So by applying KVL, we can calculate the value of PIV as 2VM. And so this is the difference between the half-wave rectifier and full-wave rectifier. In half-wave rectifier, we have seen that we have used only single diode. But in full-wave rectifier, we have used two diodes. Full-wave rectifier is also of two types, center type and bridge rectifier. And ripple factor of full wave rectifier is 0.48 and that's that of half wave it is 1.21. So it means the AC component in full wave is less in comparison to the half wave, and also the VDC output is more, efficiency is more in full wave rectifier. So these are the differences between the half wave rectifier and full wave rectifier. So thank you.